brought to you by Blazer, Sauer & Sons, Linke, Minox, and presented by Modern Huntsman. Tuscany, in the southwest corner of the state, on top of a hill in the wild Maremma region, sits Castello Vicarello.
We are on our way up a hill in Tuscany, just outside of Siena, to meet for the first time Mr. Oliver, who is an amazing knife maker. He was introduced to me a couple of years ago, and I've been completely, madly in love with his work ever since. And he offered to make a knife for me.
After the very first hello, it's clear that our paths are crossed for a reason, and I'm very excited to finally get my hand around my new knife.
Let me show you your knife.
First house!
This is the knife right there.
The grip is just incredible.
Simple and functional. Yeah. That's what you need now.
Yeah.
Like
a knife in all black, well, that just seems to fit the fashion coat perfectly.
Thank you very much.
Well knifed up, I continue south to Castello Vicarello. This trip and hunt will be special for many different reasons. The day-to-day at the Castello is run by brothers Neri and Corso. Aside from the super luxe accommodations, a key attraction is the wild game-based kitchen and the spectacular dishes served to the fortunate guests. Neri and Corso were raised based on respect for nature, steeped deeply in hunting traditions that fostered a lifelong conservation advocacy.
Matt!
My friend Matt from New York has flown in together with his wife Yolanda for a few days of hunting and cooking up on the hill. Matt owns men's lifestyle magazine, The William Brown Project, and is a fellow lifelong hunter and foodie.
Matt, how are you? I want to say it.
Nice to meet you guys.
Hey, Hunter, how are you?
Well, good. Yourself?
Good, mate.
Corso is just returning from a few days of duck hunting in the Venetian Lagoon, and he's bringing a lot of fine ducks for the kitchen and the hungry guests.
You gonna work these? Or are you gonna hand them off to somebody else?
I'm gonna let the kitchen do their job first. You know, I taught them at the beginning of the season how to do them, and now they know. So I mean.
Hello.
Hey, Yanni.
I come bringing gifts.
Ooh la la.
You brought some stuff. I brought some stuff.
This is so great.
Yeah, shot all the pictures, hunted the stuff, cleaned it, cooked it.
What recipe did you do with the bear?
I did several different ones. So I had it tested for trichinosis.
Yeah, that's the danger.
Yeah, bears and wild boars are the two that carry trichinosis. Traditionally, in Italy, wild boar meat, and in most places, wild boar meat had been cooked all the way through.
Matt's wife, Yolanda, runs her own travel magazine full of beautiful imagery and bright travel and lifestyle-related ideas.
Mm-hmm. They don't test it for trichinosis. They test it for other things. Huh. Yeah, correct. The meat I hunt myself, usually it goes through a turbo chiller. You kill all the bacteria inside, and then you can eat it easily without any problems.
Okay.
It's part of what we do here. I mean, I've always brought up, you only shoot what you eat and nothing goes to waste.
Right. Wild pigeon and duck breast are on tonight's menu and it looks fantastic.
The fish?
It's the
tripes.
It's the stomach of the fish.
Yeah.
It's incredible. Mm.
This one is the tortelli with inside the braised meat. Danny is having a crema di cannellini with black kale.
Crispy black kale.
The boys are boys. Time to play with toys.
Blazer R8.
Blazer and Sauer and Sons send us some new guns to try out. And as I expected, Matt immediately fell in love with the K95 Lux with its handmade case and beautiful wood.
So it's just single shot, correct?
Single shot. That's all you need.
One.
Hopefully.
I do like the way this gun feels.
Yeah, it feels weird to do that. I agree.
Please don't shoot that expensive camera.
A successful hunt. By the way, it's already a successful trip.